You know why I don't trust CNN or why I don't watch CNN? Because I'm too smart for them. I'm not trying to toot my own horn saying that I'm smarter than anyone else. The reason I'm too smart for them is because I do my own research. I don't just watch the mainstream news stations. I listen to alternative news. I read. I listen to podcasts. I listen to international news. So by the time I see something on CNN, I know better than to believe what they're doing. CNN, at least since I've been paying attention, has never, ever, ever been interested in providing you the truth. They're interested in providing you a narrative. And more, I'm seeing it come to light. And I watched Don Lemon last night. And again, this is just more proof how CNN is fake. They're perpetuating a narrative. They're not interested in giving you the news. I saw a clip come out from Don Lemon's show, which should be called the I Hate Donald Trump Show. It's not based in news. It's not based in fact. It's based on Don Lemon's hatred towards Donald Trump. And you can see it. Look at his face throughout the whole show. He's always smug. He's always bitter. And he reports based on his emotions and not on anything that has to do with fact. So I saw a clip from Don Lemon's show where he's saying, Trump, what do you have against Obama? Is it because he's better looking, more successful, this and that? What is it, Trump?
President Trump can't show either. By the way, what is it about President Obama that really gets under your skin? Is it because he's smarter than you? Better educated? Made it on his own? Didn't need daddy's help? Wife is more accomplished, better looking. I don't know. What is it? What is it about him that he's a black man that's accomplished, became president, that he punked you on the whole birth certificate thing? What is it about him?
First of all, Donald Trump is a millionaire. His wife used to be a supermodel. He's the president of the United States. I don't think he has any reason to not like President Obama rather than maybe having to clean up the huge mess that President Obama left behind when he got into office. I think that's what it is. So he then tries to accuse Trump of mishandling the whole pandemic situation by taking these two clips or several clips that are completely out of context, far away from each other, puts them next to each other to try to prove his point. Well, guess what, Don Lemon? I'm not that stupid. You want to know why? Because I watch the 2-hour press briefings almost every single day. I've watched Donald Trump in interviews, and I've actually seen some of those clips in full, the ones that you took out and cut down completely out of context. And I'm smart enough to know this is not news. This is you taking clips out of context, putting them together to try to fit the narrative that you're perpetuating on your show. You will do anything and everything to make Donald Trump, or to try to make Donald Trump look bad. If you have half a brain, if you have been watching the press briefings, you know that Trump has not been incompetent at all. And he's making it seem like Donald Trump is just making up these numbers and all willy-nilly talking and not being compassionate. No, that's not what happened. He's been very compassionate. He's had a 2-hour press briefing just about every single day. I think just last week or the week before, he finally stopped doing them every single day. Do you think Obama would have done a 2-hour press briefing every single day? He answered almost every single question. The only questions he didn't were from ridiculous news networks like CNN, who asked awful and pointed and emotional questions. Hold for plane. Welcome to Hollywood. There's always a helicopter or a plane hovering somewhere. The reason the numbers are kind of all over the place isn't because Donald Trump is incompetent. It's because the experts got the numbers wrong. He's not supposed to be a public health expert. He is the president. Everyone got the numbers wrong. And when they said 1 million or 2 million deaths, that was their projected deaths if we didn't do any mitigation, if we didn't do any stay-at-home orders. And if Don Lemon actually did his research or actually cared about presenting the truth to you, he would have said that and not tried to take it out of context, making Trump look like an idiot. And this is what CNN does. I've seen it for years. Another example, I think a few years ago, Donald Trump went to, was it Philadelphia? I could be getting this wrong, but he went to, I think it was Philadelphia. He went to Philadelphia. He went to a hospital to visit some people there. He went somewhere. CNN, all they covered was all the people that were like booing his car as it was coming up to the hospital. What they didn't show is like an hour's worth of footage of Donald Trump walking through the hospital, talking to patients, talking to doctors, talking to nurses, answering questions, shaking hands, giving hugs. They're all clapping for him. You will not see that on CNN. And it's really disturbing that they call themselves the trusted news source, but that's what they're banking on. They're banking on that you are not going to do your research. They're banking on that they are your only trusted news source, and they're banking on you not knowing any better and just listening and gobbling and eating up whatever it is that they tell you. That's what they're doing. And that's why they think they can get away with the Chris Cuomo thing, why they think they can get away with Don Lemon having his I Hate Trump show every night. And people, do better. If you're going to watch CNN, also do your research and know what you're watching. The other news outlets do this? Yes, probably, but no one is near as bad as CNN. Okay, that's what I have for you now. Thank you.